Hi friends, so today we will have a discussion about another data structure called as a queue. Queue is treated as a first-in, first-out data structure. So we can see a lot of real-life example in the case of queue. See, a railway ticket booking is an example of a queue, or a cinema ticket booking is an example of a queue. The first person who is standing in front of the queue will be processed first. In the similar manner, the queue will be taking place in the case of data structures in the computer field or the software field also. So the two entities that is related in the case of the queue operations is, one is a front-end and the other is a rear-end. The insertions will be taking place to the rear end, and deletions will be taking place to the front end. So tailor these both values in your mind, front and the rear. Based on this front and rear, we will be performing the program in the C++. So before moving to a concept, let us have a real life example. So I have a box. The speciality behind the box in this case of queue is both side is open. This both side of the queue has been opened. So I'm just going to insert a data value into this box. The first data value that I have entered into this box will be exited first. Okay, this is called as a entering side, and this is called as an exit side. So the insertion takes place in this section. So these sections can be treated as a rear end, and the deletion takes place in this side. Okay. So I'm just going to insert the first data value, that is the first shuttlecock. Next, I'll be inserting the second shuttlecock. Okay, next I'll be inserting the third shuttlecock, and next I'll be inserting the fourth shuttlecock. See this. This is a exit side, or this side can be treated as a processing side. So the first shuttlecock that I have entered will be relieved or just left from this box in the first position. The second shuttlecock that I have entered will be relieving or leaving from this box in the second position. The third shuttlecock that I have entered will be leaving from the box in the third position, and the fourth and the last shuttlecock that I have entered in the fourth position will be leaving from this queue in the fourth place. So this is just a real life example to show how the queue operations will be performing. Okay, now we can move on to a program. In the program, we are implementing the three strategies. That is, one, to insert the data values into the data structure named as a queue. A queue is a linear data structure. And the next will be displaying the data values in the queue. And the third operations will be deleting the data value that is being stored in the queue. Okay, now we can move on to a program. So now we will work out on the concept queue with the help of the code using C++. So we have included three important libraries, that is input output stream, code IO, console input stream, and the process stream. That is, we have used some sort of building functions like cout, cin, get, ch, exit, etc. So in order to execute that particular functions, we need the help of these libraries, input output, code IO, and process. And after that, we have used a preprocessor directive, and we have initialized this symbolic constant fsmax with a value 3. You can see that, and after these steps we are declaring three important functions related to the queue. First one is insert, second one is delete, and the third one is display. Okay, and next we have declared three important variables. First one is an array variable, that is queue with a maximum capacity of 3. Then the next one is rear and front. As we have already discussed, the rear is a place where the insertion is taking place into a queue, and front is a place where the deletion is taking place into a queue. So we initialize the value of rear and front as -1. Then we will move on to our main function, where we have a choice. We have declared a choice in integer, and we are accepting the choice from the user. We have four choices in front of us. First choice is moving for the insertion operation. The second choice will be moving towards a deletion operation. Third choice will be moving towards a display operation. And the fourth choice is to get out from this particular code. So if you are not in, entering these four choices, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, definitely the wrong choice will be working on. That is a default choice, that is, we have entered a wrong choice. You have to try again once more. So this is all about the main functions, and after that we can see the function separately, that is important function separately, insert, delete and display. Okay, so first of all we will just move on to the insertion operation, or the insertion code in a queue. This is a code snippet for the insertion operations. Here we have declared a variable named as item with a data type integer. And first of all, we are checking that if rear is equal to max capacity -1, that is the maximum capacity is 3. We are implementing queue with the help of array. So the starting location of array starts from 0, that is
the maximum capacity is 3, so the arrival comes up to the location 2, that is 0, 1, 2. Here we are checking the condition, that is if rear is equal to max capacity, maximum minus 1, then we can say that our queue is full. Okay, and then if we try to insert the value into a queue, then it comes up to the overflow states. Else, we can insert the values into a queue. So, here we are inserting the value into a queue and place that value into item, and after each insertion, the value of rear will get incremented. Okay, so we can try out the program with the help of these steps. First of all, we are going to insert the first value, front equal to 0, and item is equal to, we are going to insert the value 10, and we are assigning the value to the variable named as item. So item is equal to 10, then after that we are incrementing the rear. We are incrementing the rear variable. So the rear, initially the value of rear is minus 1, so minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. Then in the specific location in an array named as queue, we are going to insert that particular item. So initially for locations we start from 0, that is the value of rear is 0, so the rear of 0 is equal to 10, that is queue of 0 is equal to 10. Okay, so that is for the first step. And if we are going to insert the second value into the queue, then these steps will occur. That is, if I am just going to insert the value named as 20, and the rear pointer will get incremented after that. During the last stage, the value of rear is 0, so here it will increment it. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, then q of rear is equal to item, means here the value of rear is 1, so q of 1 is equal to 20. So in the first position of an array named as q, the value of 20 will get inserted. So the front positions will be the starting position, that is 0 position, and the rear position will get incremented. Here it will get incremented up to the maximum capacity, that is 2. Okay, so that is all about the second insertion process. And if I just going to insert the third item into the queue, that is 30. 30 will be assigned to the variable named as item, and the value of rear will get incremented. So during the last stage, the value is 1. So here it will get incremented to plus 1. That is, the value get incremented to 2. Then the array will that is queue of rear is equal to item, means queue of 2 is equal to 30. That is, we are assigning the value 30 into the particular location. That is, here the particular location is 2. So here we are assigning the value 30 into 2. So the rear gets incremented to the second locations. So this is the final step, the final structure of the queue after the three insertion steps. Now we cannot able to insert new item into the queue because the queue is full. So this is all about the insertion operation. Next we just move on to the another operation called as the deletion operation. Now we move on to the deletion operation. So this is a code snippet behind the deletion operations. We are checking, in the first stage we are checking that if friend equal to minus 1 or the friend is greater than rear, then definitely we can say that the queue is empty, or we can say that it is in the underflow state. Else we can say the element is deleted from the queue, that is queue of friend. That is, here you can see the output of the first deletion operation from the queue. It is Q of front. Here Q of front is equal to Q of 0 is equal to 10. As we already know, Q is a first in first out data structure. So Q of front means front is a pointer which is standing here in the 0th location. So Q of 0 is equal to 10. So it will get deleted. That is, front equal to front plus 1 means the pointer of the front will get updated from the 0th location to the first location. So the output will be like this after the first deletion operation. Then we move to the second deletion operation, then the queue stage will be queue of 1. Queue of 1 is equal to 20, then front will get incremented, that will get incremented to the second location. So in during the first stage, the front is in the 0 position. So after the deletion of the 0 position, the front will get incremented to the first position. After the deletion of the first position element, the front will get incremented to the second position. So this is the output of the program after the second deletion operation. And after that we will move on to the third deletion operation. Then the q will equal to q of 2, means q of 2 is equal to 30, so it will get deleted from the queue. So if we just try to display the stack, then definitely, sorry, if we just try to display the queue, definitely it will be empty. So this will be the output of the queue after deletion operation of the third step, that is in the second position. Okay, this is all about the code of deletion. Then we can move on to the code of display. Okay, So this is a code snippet of the display operations. Here we have declared a variable named as I based on the data type integer. And first of all, we are going to check the conditions whether the queue is empty or not. That is, if friend is equal to negative 1 or minus 1 or friend greater than rear, then definitely we can say that queue is empty. Else, we just want to display the elements of the queue. Since we have implemented the queue with the help of array, we need the help of for loop to display the values that have been present inside that array named as queue. Okay, so during the first step, for I is equal to friend means friend stands for the 0th location. So for friend is equal to 0 and rear is equal to 2. This is what the output after the insertion operation. So friend pointer will be pointing towards the 0th locations and rear pointer on the rear variable will be pointing towards the 2nd location. So friend is equal to 0 and rear equal to 2. Then during the first iteration stage, for I is equal to 0, that is for I is equal to friend means here friend is equal to 0. So I is equal to 0, 0 less than or equal to 2, and after this for loop the I will get incremented. So the C out here we are implemented a C out, that is Q of I. During the first iteration the value of I is 0, so the output will be 10. That is this one. Okay, during the second iterations, for I is equal to 1, that is after this first iteration the value of I will get incremented. So during the second stage the value of I will get incremented from 0 to 1, 1 less than or is equal to 2, and after this for loop I will get incremented to I plus b. So here we are displaying the position of the element present in the first location of the array named as q, that is q of 1 is equal to 20, as you can see here. Then after that, during the third iteration process, we are just going to output the element that's been present in the second location of the queue, that is for I is equal to 2, 2 less than or equal to 2, and we are going to display the element that has been present in the second location of the array named as queue. So output will be 30. So this is all about the display operation. So during the display operations, we need the help of a for loop, that is we have implemented the queue with the help of an array, that's why we need the help of a for loop. So this is all about the program. The main operations behind the program is insertion, display, and also the conditions. Q stands for the first in, first out matrix access, and we can execute the program. So we have implemented the program of Q with the help of C++. This is a program, and now we are going to execute the program. So just Control F9. This is the output screen. And there will be four choices. First one is to insert element into the queue, second one is to delete an element from the queue, third one is to display the elements present in the queue, and fourth one is to exit out from the program. So I'm just going to enter my first choice. Enter your options. So I'm just going to enter the first option, then after clicking enter the element. So I'm just going to enter the element 10. Okay, enter. So the queue, the present queue is only single element is being present there, that is 10, and the queue is 10. Okay, then I'm just going to enter my second choice. I'm just going to insert another element. So I just selected the choice as 1. Okay, after that I'm just going to enter the element 20. So now the queue has changed to 10 20, that is I have inserted two elements, 10 and 20. And now I'm just going to display my queue. So I'll just enter my option 3. Here you can see I just enter my option 3. So the output will be Q, the present elements in the queue, that is Q is 10, 20. And now I'm just going to delete an element from the queue. As you already know, Q is a first in, first out data structure. So the first element inserted is 10. So the first element that will be going to get deleted will be 10. So 2. That is my choice. And enter. And now the queue is 20, means the first element inserted into stack 10 is get deleted. So now the queue has only a single element, that is 20. So this is how the program of the queue works. And if I want to exit from this program or exit from the output screen, I'm just selecting the choice 4. So this is how the program of the queue works with the help of C++. Just try to execute the code. All the best.